What is going on, guys? This is the British Ambition. If you're wondering what the hell's going on right now, I am very hungover. Last night was a friend's birthday party, whatever. If you're wondering why the mic quality shit is, because I'm not about to go to the proper Blue Yeti yet. I am making this video though as I am making this little wow. This hangover's bad. I am making this beginning intro for Relentless Wrestling today, just to apologize again, once again, for the delay on this episode. It just wasn't up to the standards that I wanted it to be, and for an episode that was going to be an hour and 30 minutes, I needed that to be cut down, not in a bad way, because Relentless Wrestling doesn't need to be always 1 hour and 30 minutes. The idea of like cutting it down wasn't to cut it down because it was an hour and 30 minutes. It was to cut it down because the quality of the matches just wasn't good enough. And also, we had a few mistakes in the promo that will be played in the show. So we've just brushed that up and we've made some adjustments. Also some adjustments to some of the matches. As a bonus, we have included one more match. And I believe the video is just shy of 1 hour and 12 minutes. So it's a little bit shorter. But again, it's not a bad thing. It's more so a good thing. Anyway, guys, I'm going to let you guys enjoy this episode of Relentless Wrestling. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart for the support over the last 7 weeks. And I had a two-week break in between that. So, you know, thank you so much for the last 2 months of support on this project. Shockwave will be coming up on the 12th of November. That's a stuck date. Episode 8 will be another shorter episode. It probably will be just over an hour. We will still have the two tag matches, of course, per show. The only episode that won't have the two tag matches will be episode 9. But episode 9 will be mainly focused on the main event of Shockwave. And next week's episode will be mainly focused on building up the rest of the matches at Shockwave. So I just wanted to give you guys that update again. Sorry for the delay, and I hope you enjoyed the show. Have a good one, guys. I've always thought of my own direction. No one can pull me out. I've always felt different from the others. I'm running away.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Relentless Wrestling. This is episode 7, and we're going to open up with a banger of a match, a technical masterpiece. It will be Matt Collins and Alpha. I can't wait to see this one.
The opening contest in tonight's episode is a singles match set for 1-4. Introducing first, from Kill Devil Hill, North Carolina, weighing 225 pounds, technical Matt Collins.
And Matt Collins has been one of the most technical wrestlers of any roster that we have seen. NWA, BAWA, and most importantly here tonight in Relentless Wrestling. He has been one of the most technically gifted athletes we have ever seen. With the 40 bang, tonight we will see the match between the 40 bang knee and the 50 cal knee. It's going to be a great match, I can tell you that. Look at him, he looks so ready, he looks pumped, ready for this match. I can't wait to see him and Alpha tangle in this ring. Alpha just come off a debut, wasn't successful, but a very decent debut against the George Alexander, who beat Matt Collins a little easier than he beat Alpha, I can tell you that. And here he comes, fan favorite, here in Birmingham.
And his opponent from Chicago, Illinois, weighing in at 219 pounds, Alpha.
And Alpha looks so ready, looks confident now. I don't know how or what he's gonna do here. Was unsuccessful last week when he came up against the face of the United States in the face of the United States Open Challenge, but tonight is a different match. He's gonna face Matt Collins, a very game Matt Collins, who wants to get back on a winning streak. All he has to do tonight is beat Alpha, but Alpha needs to get into winning ways in Relentless Wrestling, and it has to start tonight. Matt Collins is ready. Alpha is ready. Larry Andrews rings the bell and we start this match. And oh, Matt Collins went straight for Alpha. Reverse, a nice leg sweep from Alpha. And oh, there's that disaster kick. And a double stomp with that, but here comes Matthew Collins. Now Matt Collins now, he has been known for about 5 years here, trained by Harvey. Doesn't follow Harvey's little roots, but he is trained by Harvey. Collins into the cover, but a kick out at one by Alpha. Alpha now, oh, nice forearm from Matt Collins. Collins now throws him into the corner. And a nice moonsault from the middle rope from Matt Collins. Look at him taunting. Alpha not looking too comfortable in there with a technical athlete like. Oh, nice pump kick there from Matt Collins, and a springboard Phoenix splash, amazing for Matt Collins, and a kick out from Alpha at one again. And now Matt Collins throws into the other corner, chop, and then oh, nice reversal from Alpha, and oh, Alpha, what a plex that was. Two, oh, I think he calls that the Alpha Exploder, but that was a pretty gnarly move, my friend. Straight landed on his head. Wow. And a chop from Alpha to Matt Collins. And Collins slapping. Rene drops now Alpha down. Alpha's down now. Oh, there's the 40 bang. 40 bang knee strike. Alpha's down. Count of two. Oh, he got the shoulder up. But barely. And Matt Collins to the top rope. And here comes. Oh, nice punch from Alpha. And down, oh, a chop from the top rope. And to the top rope again goes Matt Collins. Matt Collins on the top rope. What is he thinking here? Phoenix Splash, no. Missed. And Alpha's in position. What's Alpha got going here? Huge punch drops. Matt Collins. And Collins and Alpha. Alpha throws Collins to the rope. Up he goes. Oh! Throw him up. Onto the face goes Collins. Oh, nice reversal from Collins here. Alpha with a reversal. Collins with some elbows. Going back and forth. A technical match this is. Nice as it goes. Drops. Alpha. Alpha in the corner. And there comes Collins. No, reversal from Alpha. back and forth. Alpha's got him, the 50 cal. On his way, he connects. 50 cal into the cover. One, two, oh my god, I thought that was it. Elbows from Alpha. I legit thought Alpha had him with a 50 cal and won there. Reversal from Matt Collins. Collins gets reversed. Forearm from Matt Collins. What is this? Oh my god, a springboard into a stomp. Collins going for the 40 bang. Collins going for the 40 bang knee strike. Oh, and he connects. Into the cover. Oh no. What's Collins going thinking here? He hit with a 40 bang. Tech Plex. Connects with the Tech Plex. Going for the 40 bang. Once again. Look at this. He thinks he's done it. Whoa! Alpha recovers in a forearm into the corner. Going for something. Kick to the back of Alpha. 40 bang. Dodge. Oh, Alpha's got him. Alpha's got him. The 50 cal. 50 cal. Out of nowhere. One, two, and Alpha has beaten Matt Collins. A very game. Matt Collins has just been beaten and bested by Alpha.
Here is your winner, Alpha.
And wow, Alpha and Matt Collins. Oh, what's going on here? Alpha offers the hand and a handshake between the two. Mutual respect between these two men. Amazing. To see that, so happy and so nice to see that here in Relentless Wrestling.
The following contest is the second round of the Tag Team Round Robin. Introducing first, at a combined weight of 556 pounds, Alan Johnson, Antonio Johnson, the BMW Boyz.
Unsuccessful in their first match against the Yardie Boyz. Got pretty unlucky actually if you think about it. Yardie Boyz was on the edge of losing and then suddenly they turned it around. Yardie Boyz have been getting very lucky like that very often, and I gotta say, the BMW Boyz, Antonio and Alan Johnson, they really need to turn things around here if they want to continue on in this round robin tournament. But they are up against some game opponents who, you know, probably should be favorites for the tournament, but they also didn't win last week.
And their opponents, at a combined weight of 427 pounds, Colt Lee and Treason, Seek and Destroy.
And here comes Seek and Destroy. You know, the favorites for the tournament at the start, probably because they are both investors into the company. 20% each they own in Relentless Wrestling, Colt Lee and Treason. However, unfortunately for, you know, the whole thing, the Seek and Destroy. You know, their leader, Harvey, kept quiet. Speaking of the leader, you know, Harvey apparently isn't here tonight, so the show has been run by these two. But as you heard on the Discord server, that, you know, the fourth investor will be revealed tonight at some point, and we're just waiting on that. And the match is underway, and already Trees is trying to go for something there. And oh, nice move from Trees, and oh, a spinning heel kick drops Alan Johnson. And there's a sling blade there. And Colt Lee is now tagged in. Looking good, Seek and Destroy so far. Nice to see them. Colt Lee's taking down Alan Johnson. Antonio on the outside. Forearm from Colt Lee. Into a stunner on the rope. And Alan Johnson in trouble now on the knee from Colt Lee. And oh, wow. That was a nice move from Treason, taking down Alan Johnson. And Alan Johnson now thrown into the corner. Running knee from Colt Lee. Setting up these Boston knee parties. And oh, nice kip up there from Alan Johnson to kick Colt Lee into the corner. And oh, kicks the rope up into his leg. Wow. Colt Lee in trouble. Oh, look at his choke into the corner, and oh, a meteor in the corner, and Alan Johnson's happy with himself on that one. An impressive move there, into the cover, one, oh, kick out from Colt Lee, not letting that go any further than it needs to be. Remember, Harvey is not in the building, not in action tonight. Must play an effect, because he is the leader of Seek and Destroy. Must play an effect on their minds that, you know, he's not here tonight. It's a bit of an interesting one. And Antonio Johnson now. Oh, nice knee. Treason wanted something, but he missed. And Antonio Johnson taking it to Colt Lee. Colt Lee's been put down. Treason's trying to get involved. Treason can't get it. And what is this from Antonio Johnson? And oh, snake eyes, but Colt Lee's there with a lethal combination and takes out Alan Johnson as well. And Colt Lee now double underhook, brainbuster connects. A lot of intrigue in this match, because both these teams lost on episode 6, which means both these teams are in quite deep trouble of being eliminated from the round robin. I mean, if you lose this match, you might as well say goodbye. It's kind of a blessing that you got this match, though, because if you lose this one, and let's say Vex and Hex or Yardie Boyz lose later on tonight, you know, the winner of this match is only in the same position as that team. But as I said, you do not want to be the loser of this match if you are Seek and Destroy. Because it is completely out of your hands if Vex and Hex faces BMW Boyz next week. And there's a tag to Alan Johnson, a hot tag. Off the ropes goes Treason. Thrown into the ropes again. A nice kitchen sink from Alan Johnson. Johnson now, springboard forearm. Now Johnson is on fire. Someone needs to pull him out. Nice punch. Nice reversal. Oh, crucifix roll up. Alan Johnson's in trouble. No, kick out. Alan Johnson gets a kick to the leg. Nice reversal from Alan Johnson. Elbow into a bulldog. And what is this? Foreclosure incoming. Oh, reversal. Alabama slam. Nice move from Treason to get out of that one. Amazing. Oh, elbow. CCS Insecurity. drops Drazen out of the corner, shoots the half, into the cover. Oh, broken up from Coley, just in the nick of time. Oh, there's a snare drop, drops Allen Johnson. And Antonio had been put down. Oh, nice reversal here from Drazen, drops Antonio Johnson. Allen Johnson comes out, hurricanrana, punches, Drazen's in trouble. Cole Lee now, what is this? Off the ropes, and oh, and Antonio moves out of the way and knees him on top of him. And BMW boys are looking very confident here. So you can destroy now. I'm trying to get back into this. Count of six. Reversal from Treason. Count of seven. Both men need to get in the ring now. And Treason gets into the ring. Allen Johnson into the ring. Allen Johnson has... Oh, run a knee. Drops. Treason's in trouble. Treason's trying to call. And he got him. Hot tag from Treason. Here comes Coley. Pump kick. Boston knee, but no. Reversal. Boston knee, bro. What a reversal from Antonio Johnson. Johnson into the cover. One. Two. Oh. A kick out from Coley at two. And a reversal from Coley. Coley with a mini moonsault. Oh. Antonio Johnson moves out of the way. Oh, both men shoulder into each other. Reversal for Coley. Cole 45. Connects. Oh, and a knee from Allen Johnson, not allowing that to go any further. What is this from Coley? Corkscrew. Springboard. Crossbody. Takes out Allen Johnson. Allen Johnson gets a double underhook. Brainbuster on the outside. Into the ring. Clothesline. A second clothesline. And a third clothesline. And Treason now. In position. Down goes Allen Johnson again. It is time for static feedback. And it connects. There it is. Static feedback. Into the cover goes Seek and Destroy. To go 3 points in on the round robin. And they do. Seek and Destroy has just beaten the BMW boys. And the BMW boys are not in a good position to go through to the finals at the pay-per-view.
Here are your winners. Coley and Treason. Seek and Destroy. The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the Relentless Wrestling YouTube Television Championship.
Well, this is going to be a very interesting one. A lot of backstage talk for this guy. He wanted it, and now he's got it. But I don't think he has very good chances.
Introducing first, from St. George, Utah, weighing at 155 pounds, Virgil, Ken.
I mean, just look at this guy's entrance. He's got arms like noodles. He's got a shirt and the Superman logo, but instead of the S, it just says nerd in it. I mean,
got brains on the back, there's Kent in the middle, he's got bow tie and these trunks. I mean, the guy's got glasses on. I mean, I wouldn't personally hit a guy with the glasses on, but you know, he's come out here like he dressed for a match, but also as if it's a sport. This isn't just a sport. This is a fight you're about to get into with one of the most dominant champions in this company. Standing at 6'5", weighing in at almost 300 pounds, Brandon Briggs has been a television champion wherever he goes. You see what he did at Platinum. We've seen what he did to Pickle Chips on episode 2. And now we're seeing him here in Relentless Wrestling on episode 7, defending the television championship once again. And it's this guy, the Bull, Brandon Briggs, has become one of the most fierce competitors in the company, accompanied to the ring by Philly Butcher and representing the Butcher Collective. Him and George Alexander have been the two faces of our mid-card scene, and I can't lie to you, it might be not just for now, but for a very long time. And his opponent, accompanied to the ring by Philly Butcher, from Houston, Texas, weighing in at 289 pounds, he is the Bull, Brandon Briggs. Brandon Briggs looks so ready. If I was Virgil Ken, I'd just walk out the ring right now. I don't think he has a shot, honestly. Look at the size difference between these two men. However, don't write it off. The television championship is on the line. The YouTube television championship is on the line. That might be the closest you get to the title, kid. As Larry Andrews holds up the YouTube Television Championship. How long are we saying, guys? The Bull is ready. Virgil Ken is ready. Here we go. Both men walk into the center of the ring. And oh! Oh my God! My God, the Bull's lining him up for a spear. What a spine buster that was. It's a spear from the Bull. Brandon Briggs has just flatlined him. Oh my God. Well, that was quick. Here is your winner, and still, the Relentless Wrestling YouTube Television Champion, Brandon Briggs. Yeah.
impressive victory, and still YouTube television champion Brandon. Behind you, Brandon. Coyle Brody, what is he doing here? Well, you saw Coyle, you know who's not far behind. Robert is here, and what has he got to say? Are we about to see these two men at Shockwave? Gigantic match. Well, that video says it all. Shockwave theme song has just been revealed.
thank you, Veer Union, for doing a song. We'll see you at Shockwave on November 12th, where Jonathan will main event and this tag team tournament will culminate with a winner.
Oh my god, this is the second round of the tag team round robin. Introducing first, at a combined weight of 405 pounds, coming to the ring by Liminos and Viscera, Cadaverous, Radovant, Vexing, Hex.
And this team has been unstoppable. I can't even lie to you. I've not seen anything like this. A very mystical team. You know, accompanied to the ring by Liminos and Viscera. And you really see like a whole like a faction brewing here. I mean, they helped Vex and Hex beat Seek and Destroy last week. This week, someone's O must go. They've been undefeated for this long, but Yardie Boyz and Vex and Hex, someone must lose their record here tonight. And Radaman in the ring now. He looks ready to go. Cadaverous right behind him as he... Oh, look at that. Big flames from the corner. He looks excited. He looks ready to get in the ring, win another one. Vex and Hex have been one of the most dominant teams in the tournament thus far. But here's another team who hasn't lost yet in the tournament.
And their opponents, at a combined weight of 450 pounds, Shamaru, Javar Payne, the Yardie Boyz.
These boys look ready. They look how energetic these two are. They have more energy in this entrance than the entirety of any match they have participated in. Actually, that might be false too. There's a super kick right into a corkscrew shooting star press that Javar Payne delivers. And Shamar Gordon with just an exciting moveset, a standing 450 splash on his opponent. I can't even lie to you. These two men, they have been very good in the tournament so far. They haven't lost. They're one of the two teams that haven't lost in the round robin, but they have also been undefeated in the entirety of their time here in Relentless Wrestling alongside Vex and Hex. So one of these teams must lose, and we're gonna have to find out which one it is here tonight. Let's go, Yardie Boyz, Vex and Hex. And the bell has officially been rung. Both teams in here, and a big shoulder tackle there by Cadaverous. Cadaverous now, I have to be honest, Cadaverous has been very impressive over the last few weeks. Same with Radaman. Both men delivering on their promises. And look at that tag team move there from Rex and Hex. And now Radaman face first goes Javar Payne on the mat, and you gotta see this tag work between the two, and it's very technically sound. Dressed in paint, dressed in black and wearing white face paint with, oh, nice elbow there with some black glow around the eyes. They have been hexed, and it's, you know, quite clear to see it. Liminos and Viscera, they were here last week. They even played a big part in their victory against Seek and Destroy. Will we see another victory here for Vexing Hex, or would Yardie Boyz stop their momentum right in their tracks? The Vexing Hex have been all over the place, and you know, as we get back into the action here, I gotta say Vexing Hex has been dominating the match so far, and just holding him over the rope. Referee get in there, he's choking him over the rope, and oh, he yanks him off, and look at him taunting. It's an easy match so far for Vexing Hex. Vexing Hex has been very, very good here, and a big boot drops down Javale Payne. Javale Payne has had no offense as of yet in this match, and Vexing Hex looking a very good. Oh, Javale Payne shoulder barges. Bannerman went for something there, and what is this? An exploder suplex throws Radiman across the ring, and Radiman in trouble. Oh, went for a running forearm. Radiman blocks it. Big boot from Radiman, and an elbow drop. Oh, Javale Payne moves out of the way. Drop kick. Down goes Radiman. Radiman has gone down, and Javale Payne throws him into the corner. Needs a breather. Goes for a tag move here. Look at that forearm. Look at that. It's good work in here from Javale Payne getting out of that one. And oh, alley-oop bomb. Radiman goes down. Radiman's been hurt. Oh, but Javale Payne gets kicked off. And oh, just went straight for Shamar Gordon for no reason, attacking him. And a tiger bomb in the center of the ring into the cover. One, two. Oh, kick out from Javale Payne. Javale Payne needs to make attack here. The Yardie Boyz ain't going to be. Oh. Nice dodge with a leg drop there. Nice drop kick again for Javale. Javale into the cover, but cadaverous breaking that up before it even goes. And look at that. Shamar Gordon spinning back kick. Cadaverous goes down. Nice reversal from Radiman. Nice punch to the gut. Two punches. Three punches. Oh, look at that. And the kick to the gut from Radiman. Radiman off the ropes. Oh. Caught by Javale. Javale now trying to go for something, but three elbows from Radiman. Radiman looking good, and oh, what a knee! Drops Javale Payne. Wow. Javale Payne's been stopped dead in his tracks. There's from Radiman. Going for something, and a nice enziguri. Shamar Gordon has not been in this match once. And oh, I say that Shamar Gordon gets hot tagged in, and here comes Shamar Gordon. Gordon now going straight after Radiman. Gordon obviously the more fresh here as he looks too cadaverous. Cadaverous now looking full down. Oh, nice punch from Shamar to Radiman, and Radiman gets a DDT on the apron. Down. He just got domed. Top of his head, the cranium of his head just pounced onto the apron, and oh my god, the hardest part of the ring, and Cadaverous gets hot tagged in. He's in trouble here. Nice shoulder tackle takes out Shamar Gordon, and now Javale Payne's been dropped, and there's a knee for Cadaverous. And Liminos and Visera here helping Radiman on the outside. Shamar Gordon with a reversal. What's this for Shamar Gordon? What is this? Oh, using the ropes, on the arm lock over the ropes. Cadaverous in trouble. Drop kick drops Cadaverous. A tag into Javale Payne. Payne's in the ring. And what is this from Payne? Float over DDT. Drops Cadaverous. Oh, and a springboard into a tornado DDT. Javale Payne has just dropped Cadaverous. Cadaverous stunned. And Shamar Gordon, flashback, down goes Cadaverous, into the cover. Is Vexing Hex just lost their first match? No. A kick out just after one, nearly a two count, and into an exploder suplex. Cadaverous is in trouble here. And what is this? Oh, drop kick. What is this? Radiman. Radiman just took off the top turnbuckle, and on the left side. And oh, big back body drop. The top turnbuckle has just been removed in the corner of Radiman. Is Cadaverous going to use that to his advantage here? Oh my god, no. Reversal from Shamar Gordon. Oh.
Nice shoulder tackle. Oh! Cadaverous just blocked Javal Payne's hot tag to Shamar Gordon. And now he gets him. Javal Payne has just been tagged in. Oh, big bulldog for Cadaverous. A bulldog again for Cadaverous. Vexing, Cadaverous is taking control here. And what is this? Dropkick. The reversal from Cadaverous. Reversal for Javal Payne. This is a crazy tag match. I don't know what's going on. Into the cover. And Radaman dare to break it up. Oh my god. Oh, thank god the referee finally fixing it. Oh, what a laugh. Cadaverous just spit mist into the face of Javal Payne while the referee was fixing the top turnbuckle. Oh, come on. And oh, into the tag. Oh, come on. Javal Payne has just been hexed. Center of the ring. Shoots the half. Oh, come on. They played it dirty again. Two. And Vex and Hex are the only team undefeated in this tournament. They go 6 points up.
Here are your winners. Vexing, Hex.
What on earth is this? Jonathan was meant to commentate later tonight. He just found laid out backstage. What is going on? Why is Jonathan... Jonathan's hurt. Get some medical team back there. What's going on here?
Well, it's going to be a good one. A women's match. Set for 1-4.
The following contest is a women's match. Set for 1-4. Making their way to the ring from San Luis Potosi, Mexico. Dulce, Tormenta.
And Dulce, Tormenta, making her Relentless Wrestling debut. A luchadores from San Luis Potosi, Mexico. Looking promising here as she goes head to head against the Relentless Wrestling Women's Champion. You must think, if she makes a big victory here tonight, she can make a call for the women's title. There is nobody, no rightful contender for the title yet. And we're going into Shockwave. We're very close to it. Whoa, Dulce Tormenta be the one.
And her opponent, from Sacramento, California, she is the Relentless Wrestling Women's Champion, Siren.
This whole new swagger, this whole new look, this whole different attitude to professional wrestling claims she has started her revolution, and this is her time to shine. She has defeated Amber Oxley. She has defeated Kaeva Black. She has defeated Safina, three of the toughest women. She has defeated Dylan Cooper. It has been a very tough challenge for Siren. She has been very, very good as a champion here. She is the inaugural Relentless Wrestling Women's Champion. She was also the last ever NWA Women's Champion. This woman can go, and this is proof. This is the reason why she's one of the reasons why Harvey is the best he's ever been. And why she's in the best state she's ever been. And oh, what is this for Dulce? Oh my god, Siren's been put down. What the hell was that from Tormenta? Tormenta is taking it to Siren. Oh, but went for a Hurricanrana on Siren, but Siren caught her. Powerbomb. Drops Tormenta down. And a clothesline drops her down again. needs to focus. Siren has already been dropped on her head. A nice spear into the corner from Siren. Off into the corner. Blows a kiss. Look at Siren. Blowing a kiss. Rolls out of the way. Doja rolling. What is this? Oh. What is this from Siren? Oh, she's standing on her hair. Referee, get in there. She's standing on her hair. Siren playing dirty. Playing to her advantage. Tormenta in trouble. Nice shoulder tackle there from Siren. Blocked, it seems like, from Tormenta. Tormenta throws Siren over the top rope. Forearm. Siren to the top rope. Oh, nice forearm from Tormenta. Throws Siren down. Tormenta been very impressive. Opening up the match very quickly. But Siren has an answer for everything that she does. And Siren looking like she wanted to go for Purple Rain there. But couldn't get it. A nice forearm there from Siren. Nice knee. Oh, drops Tormenta down. Siren is a part of Seek and Destroy. Alongside with Harvey and Treason. Also Coltley. You know, Siren's husband not here tonight. One of the four investors, the 40% owner of Relentless, the CEO, the main shareholder. He's not been here. We haven't seen him. It's the first time Harvey has missed an episode. And a suicide dive to Dulce. Tormenta. Siren has been on top of this match. Dolce's had her moments, but Siren has been absolutely amazing here. I'm amazed. What is this? Oh my god, a technical masterclass. And a forearm drop Dulce. Look at that. Siren grabbing at Dulce. Dulce is in the drop zone and Siren taunting. What is this? Dulce went for, oh my god, went for a running knee and Siren just big booted her. See a lot of, oh, nice uppercut from Dulce. What is this? Double foot stomp. Oh my god. Siren has just been foot stomped on the upper chest area. Siren now in trouble. Drop down. Oh, nice. Oh, there it is. Eclipse. Oh my god. Has she just pinned the champion? Oh my god. That was so close. I thought Dulce Tormenta had it. Siren in trouble. Oh my god. A springboard moonstomp. Two. Oh, Siren barely kicks out and Tormenta getting frustrated now. Look at that. Tormenta dancing in the ring. Hurricanrana. Drop Siren. Siren's in trouble. Punch to the gut. She needs to be careful. Siren really needs to focus now. Oh, into the spear. Into the corner. Look at that, stomping her out in the corner. Purple Rain inbound. She hits this. It's lights out. Purple Rain connects. No, Dulce moved out of the way. Dulce, springboard dropkick. No. Oh, there it is. Psylocke out of nowhere. Out of nowhere, the Psylocke. And she taps out. And she taps out. She got Dulce to tap out. How quick was that from Siren? Amazing performance.
Here's your winner, Siren.
Celebrating with her title. Although the title was not on the line here, she is making sure that everyone knows she is the champion. She is the Relentless Wrestling Women's Champion. Whoever steps up to her, we need to know who it's going to be. Who the hell? Oh my god! A heel kick! Drop Siren! Who the hell was that? Oh, and a belt to the face. Is that who I think it? That's Ashley Lee. Oh my god. There it is. She was maid of honor. Oh my god. There it is. Siren was maid of honor for Ashley Lee. At the wedding. Oh, there it is. What the hell was that? Siren gets clotheslined over the top of Ashley Lee. Has just made a statement. Whoa! my word, Siren walking off the title, and look at Ashley Lee. Ashley Lee is pumped. Is this who's going to contend for the women's championship? We'll have to find out next week. Oh, I'm so excited for this one. Main event time, and it's live.
The following contest is the main event of the evening, and it will determine who will face Jonathan for the Relentless World Heavyweight Championship at Relentless Wrestling Shockwave. Introducing first, from Georgia, North Carolina, weighing at 223 pounds, Christian.
And the crowd loves this man, the fan favorite everywhere he goes, from Kill Devil Hills, North Carolina, Christian Rose is here. The fan favorite for this tournament, imagine seeing him and Jonathan go head to head. Oh man, it makes me so excited to think about that. Oh, I just can't wait to see Christian Rose and Ted Richardson here. This is going to be a fight. It's going to be a war. The crowd loves this man. But for whom the bell tolls, Ted Richardson is the man that pinned Charlie. And why I claim that is because only two men in Relentless have beaten Charlie. Harvey and Ted Richardson. Whoa.
And his opponent from San Antonio, Texas, weighing in at 244 pounds.
Ted Richardson.
Richardson.
I have to say this right now. This man is the most diabolical wrestler in the business. And what I mean by that is he's so systematic. He will work on a joint. Any joint in your body, he will work on it and make it so un... It's one of them things that hurt the most. He will make it so uncomfortable for you to even work. And this is what he did to Charlie last week. He dissected him. He hit him with an early spear, hurt him in the ribs, and he just kept aiming there, and he meant every last bit of it. And he speared him at the last bit. Probably could have pinned him off of it, but he said he wants to make sure. Throw him to the ropes, throw him up into the air, and chopped him right in half. Charlie has not been seen since. However, we do know that Charlie is 100%, he's happy, he is looking into this. He has made a claim on Twitter that he will be at Shockwave one way or another, whether it's for the title or not. So we will have to see. Ted Richardson beat him last week. Let's find out if Ted Richardson or Christian Rose will be the one to face Jonathan for the Relentless Wrestling World Championship. And a big deep arm drag as the match is ready to go. And Ted Richardson now the punch. Chop from Christian Rose. And what a diss. And oh, there he goes. Ted Richardson came running at Rose, but Rose had an answer for it. Oh, went for something, but Ted Richardson moved out of the way. Two chops, three chops, four chops in a row. It's looking like Ted Richardson last week. Into the moonsault DDT. Nice springboard. into a moonsault DDT. I've not seen something like that for Christian Rose in quite a long time. Christian Rose to the top rope. Phoenix splash to the back.
Christian Rose and Matt Collins trained together. Although Christian Rose didn't train under Harvey, Matt Collins trained with Christian Rose elsewhere. And oh my god! A Canadian destroyer!
Early in the match, not enough to put away Christian Rose, but that's gonna do a lot of damage. Christian Rose now feeling some of the effect, although he's delivering backwards.
Look at this. Big chops from Christian Rose. Throws him off the ropes. Drop down.
Oh my god, what the hell was that? Both men delivering big moves and both men kicking out at one. It's going to take a lot more to take each other out. A big running forearm from Ted Richardson.
I do want to take you guys back to last week, where Buster Gates and Christian Rose both had their match. We saw Christian Rose's Rose kick get caught into the sexual bottom, elbow, 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 and into another Rose kick to where he took the advantage. And
Ted Richardson with a big tope suicida, but Christian Rose got out of the way. And outside the ring now, Rose thunderbomb. Oh my god, did you see how Ted landed? He landed on the back of his head on the floor there. It's a hard landing.
Christian Rose is going to play that into his advantage. And Rose to the top rope could be going for Rose's R-Red. If he hits that, it might be match over.
No, oh, Ted moves out of the way. Ted's out of the way. Spear from Ted. Ted hit an early spear again. This is reminiscent of how he beat Charlie last week. Total kick out. But that spear wasn't to finish the match. That spear is to weaken you. For more spears to come. He will keep spearing you until you don't get up. Spearing symphonies are running wild from Ted Richardson.
I gotta say, Ted Richardson has been one of the most impressive wrestlers on the roster. The only man to beat Ted Richardson actually on this entire roster has been Harvey. So you have to realize that Ted Richardson is in a very good position in winning this tournament. Christian Rose has lost 3 times in Relentless Wrestling. He lost to Harvey. He lost to Charlie. And most importantly, he didn't win at Platinum Neither. A big boot from Ted Richardson. Christian Rose has not been very successful here in Relentless Wrestling. But last week, he had a number one contenders match into this match. And he won. A very serious win there for Christian Rose. Not as reminiscent of Ted Richardson's time here, where Ted Richardson has been very successful. Nice stomp to the arm. And as I was saying earlier, Ted Richardson is one of the most smartest wrestlers on the roster. He will dissect any body part if it means he will get a ring. It will get a win, sorry. And Ted to the top rope, not usually doing this.
Ted with a hurricane run off the top rope. Ted Richardson doesn't do this often. Ted's going for a spear. Ted's going for a spear. But Christian Rose kips up, goes for Ted, and Ted hits the spear. A reversal from Ted into a spear again. Ted's got Christian, no. Kick out. And Christian Rose keeps up.
Oh man, he's holding the ribs though.
Arm drag.
Christian Rose holding them ribs. Them spears are getting to him and an inaugural drops Christian Rose. And look at Ted. Ted to the corner. Could be going for another spear. Ted could be going for another spear here. This could be it. Oh, what the hell is this?
Lethal combination drops Ted on his face.
Oh, and a nice kick from Ted Richardson. Richardson going for a spear. Richardson's going for a spear. He's calling for it. Oh, what is this?
Richardson plan A. Pedigree. 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 No. Reverse Alabama slam. And Christian Rose. Rose working on the leg now. Rose. What a reversal. Alan Pedigree picks him up and Alabama slammed him.
He could be going for a Rose kick. If he gets this, it might be it.
Oh my god. Rose has got Ted Richardson up. The Rose driver. Center of the ring. Rose driver. Two. Oh,
Ted kicked out. I don't know how he kicked out of that one. but it was a pretty good kick out, if I must say. To the top rope, Rose goes. Roses are red, inbound, he connects! Rose have done it! Rose has done it! Oh, Ted kicked out! Oh my word, this match is still going. And look at this, Rose now got the leg. And look at this, punching the leg. If he's attacking the leg and the leg stop working, you can't hit the spear. Perfect strategy, but not nearly enough damage for Ted Richardson as he hits a single leg dropkick. Ted is still not damaged enough on them legs. Nice forearm from Ted Richardson. Clothesline. Into a face buster. Ted Richardson puts down Christian Rose. Rose is getting up slowly. Richardson special. Puts him up. He's got him. There it is. Razor's Edge. The Richardson special. He's got him. Ted's going to go for a spear now. Rose kick and a spear. Both men at that. Whoa. What on earth? What on earth is this? Seeking the straw. What are they doing? This match just ended in a double disqualification. The Seeking the Straw is just an act.
Oh my god.
It was a plan. He was not supposed to be here tonight. It was a plan from the get-go. Seeking the Straw has ruined a fantastic match. And now we know why. Can't you just keep your nose out of business for one night? A match that was so great and you just ruined it. Fucking hell, Harvey, come on.
The crowd are rejecting it. It's so, the crowd are so loud, oh my god.
Boys, boys, done. Job done. You see, you heard the bell ring for a disqualification, however, this match is not done. The bell rang there because the match has changed. This match is still for the right to face Jonathan and Shockwave. However, this match is now a triple threat match. And I I am the new participant.
He's the third participant? What do you mean? This ain't no triple threat match. This is scheduled for a one-on-one match. Harvey abusing his power and is now just putting himself in this match. Does that mean if Harvey wins now, he faces Jonathan and Shockwave? Harvey slowly walks into the ring. Both men are down. Ted Richardson stands up slowly. Harvey kicks him in the gut. Harvey runs the ropes. Runs for a knee. Ted reverses. Forearm. Harvey's down. Ted Richardson's going for a spear on Harvey. Rose kick to Ted Richardson. Oh my god. Harvey picks up Rose. No. Rose goes up. Finish ambition. One last breath to Rose. No. Oh come on, not this way. Oh, this is bullshit. This is absolute bullshit. For goodness sake. What on earth is this?
Usually. Harvey.
Well, it's official at Shockwave in the main event. Harvey looks to go for redemption as he faces Jonathan again.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! No way! It can't be! It can't be! We haven't seen it in 5 years, what the hell is this?
Oh my God, Mitchell Everett is here. The former BAWA World Champion, the Bluebird, has stormed into Relentless Wrestling. What is he doing here? What is this? Mitchell Everett is here. I don't believe it. I am shocked. I am so shocked. What on earth is this? What did you get to say? Mitchell Everett is in Relentless Wrestling. He is sick. He is hearing the fans speak. They are screaming. I can't believe this. He's got a microphone. What has he got to say?
That is all, and I am back.